Welcome to today's video. Today we're going to talk about creating a form or quiz utilizing Office 365. Microsoft have a feature called Microsoft Forms, and this could be an alternative to products like SurveyMonkey if you're using Office 365. So what we're going to show you is from a computer, how to create a form or a quiz, send it out to individuals or groups, and even export that information using Excel. So, sure, we're going to switch over to computer mode, and you can see the next part of the demonstration.
Welcome to part two this video, where we're going to talk about forms. Now, forms and quizzes are fairly similar in what you see at the end. But we'll go through both of them so you've got an example. So, to get to this page, all you have to do is go to forms with an S .office.com. So it's forms.office.com. And here we can create a new form. Now you've got two tabs, questions and responses. So if I click new question, so we're going to do a multi-choice question. So we could say, do you use Office 365? Yes, no, job done, just by clicking those buttons. Add new, we could have a text-based form, a rating, but we do another multi, we do a rating. How easy do you find form creation? And we can leave it as a star, we can put it as a number system, just so you can see what each of these look like. I would personally just keep it to 5 stars, makes it easier. You've got required and not required. And what we do is we just call this test form 1, and then we can do share. Now you get a link to the form. You can also share it using a QR code. Here you can embed it into a web page. And the final option is you could generate an email to send this to multiple people. So that's your preference. But that is how to create a form. Now, if you want to tinker with themes, you can click on each of these themes, and as you can see what they look like. And this is what it This is a preview of what it will look like to the person visiting. So, job done. Then go back. And that's as easy as it is to create a form. So, if you use Office 365, you could use this instead of signing up to another solution. And then from the responses tab, when people do fill it in, you see the responses, how long it took them, so you can get an idea of how long it does take to fill in your form, which is useful when you send emails saying, on average, it takes 2 minutes, or it might take 5 minutes, so you can give a more accurate answer to how long it takes. And open in Excel will create a nice Excel spreadsheet with what the responses were to the questions. so you can see them in one page. Otherwise, you have to view response a page at a time. So that's how you deal with forms in Office 365. Now, if I create a quiz, so like forms, add new, like I say, it's very similar. So multi-choice, what is the color of the sky? And you could say blue, green, and even here it's coming up with some examples, and etc. etc. The difference here is that you're saying what the correct answer is, and then you can say give it 1 point. If you want to give it multiple answers, then you put a tick against multiples. Then you can say required or not required. Likewise, a text-based one, there might be some input into what the answer will be, but you could say random questions. So who is the current Prime Minister of the UK? And then let somebody put their answer in. And then here, we put the correct answer. And that's as simple as that. Do the share thing again, same thing as before, and then we could preview point. You know, if you've been in the country a long time, you'll know that John Major is the current, not the current Prime Minister, but he was in the past. Submit, thank you for your results, and you can see that person got it wrong on that one. And that's how you use quizzes in Office 365, but it all comes from Microsoft Forms. So feel free to tinker around with this, that's Forms for you.
Welcome back. We hope you found this useful. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. If you didn't, give us a thumbs down. It's all good, useful feedback for us. And if you want to find out more useful videos like this, please click the subscribe button in the bottom right-hand corner. Thanks for watching and have a great day.